We want to solve the compound inequality and then express using interval notation. Looking at the given compound inequality, notice how it looks like we've combined two inequalities into one because it contains two inequality symbols. The key to understanding this type of inequality is to look at the middle expression first of x plus 9. The expression x plus 9 has two conditions. It must be greater than 2x plus 10, and it must also be less than or equal to 3x plus 15. So to solve this, we'll have two inequalities connected by the word and. So to solve this compound inequality, we'll have two separate inequalities connected by the word and then we'll solve each of the inequalities, graph them both on the number line, and then determine which interval would satisfy both inequalities. So starting with x plus 9 and reading from right to left, sometimes we'll reverse the order when writing this down, but since there's a variable on both sides of this inequality, we'll just write it as it is. So we'll have 2x plus 10 is less than x plus 9, and in blue from left to right, we would have x plus 9 is less than or equal to 3x plus 15. Now we'll go ahead and solve the red inequality first. Notice how we have x on both sides of the inequality, so we'll start by subtracting x on both sides. 2x minus x would be 1x, or just x, plus 10 is less than, this would be 0, so we have less than 9. And now we'll subtract 10 on both sides to solve for x. This would be 0, so we have x is less than 9 minus 10 is negative 1. Now we'll graph x as less than negative 1 on the number line. Notice negative 1 does not satisfy this inequality, so we make an open point on negative 1, and the numbers less than negative 1 are to the left. Now we'll solve the blue inequality. And since we usually prefer to have the variable on the left side of the inequality, let's go ahead and subtract 3x on both sides. This would be 0, so x minus 3x is negative 2x, plus 9 is less than or equal to positive 15. Now we'll undo the addition by subtracting 9 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have negative 2x is less than or equal to, this would be positive 6. And the last step is to divide by negative 2. But remember, when dividing by a negative, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So this would be x, and then we'll reverse the inequality symbol, so it'll be greater than or equal to, and 6 divided by 2 is negative 3. So now we'll graph x as greater than or equal to negative 3. Notice negative 3 does satisfy this inequality, so we'll make a closed point on negative 3, and then an arrow to the right for the numbers greater than negative 3. Now this is not our solution. We need to interpret this based upon, we want the interval where x is less than negative 1 and when x is greater than or equal to negative 3. So we want the interval where both of these are true, or where it's graphed twice, both in blue and red. And so we can see it's going to be the interval from negative 3 to negative 1, including negative 3 and not including negative 1. Let's go ahead and clean this graph up. The solution to this compound inequality is actually this interval here. So using interval notation, we have the interval from negative 3 to negative 1. It's closed on negative 3, or it includes negative 3, so we use a square bracket. It's open on negative 1, so we use a rounded parenthesis. So now we've expressed the solution using inequalities, using a graph, and using interval notation. I do want to make one more comment about the solution expressed using inequalities. Again, we have x is less than negative 1 and x is greater than or equal to negative 3. We could also combine these two inequalities in a similar way that the initial compound inequality was given to us. We could put the x in the middle. Then looking at the graph, we could say x is greater than or equal to negative 3 and less than negative 1. So these two mean exactly the same thing, just written in a different form. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.